You mentioned yesterday about the San Jose State defense. I think they're ranked 12th nationally in total defense. They're higher in pass defense, which is good for their conference, but maybe not necessarily applicable to this game. But your thoughts on what you're seeing out of their defense?
Really good. I mean, you know, they've played some good people. You know, they played some really good offense, played Auburn, Minnesota, you know, Nevada, just beat BYU, you know, Wyoming beat Air Force, and obviously Air Force beat us. So, you know, they're playing really sound, running to the football. You know, their defense coordinator is a really good coach, you know, been in the Super Bowl, knows what he's doing. And I'm very impressed when you watch them. Discipline, you know, they know exactly what they're doing and run to the football. It's going to be a tough game for us.
And I don't know how many players they have that have played in, you know, in the Navy game, but I know there are several. Do you think there's an advantage, the fact that they've played you now 2 years in a row prior to this coming in?
They got a lot of returns. A lot of the guys that played against us last year are playing in this game. So, you know, they know what we do. You know what I mean? And so they're going to be familiar with our offense. And like I said, this is going to be a tough challenge for us.
Greeby, he kicked extra points in the game. He got a good amount of them. So that was probably a good opportunity for him to kind of get into a game setting and kind of, you know, break the ice, if you will, gain some confidence. I know it would have been nice to get him a field goal opportunity, but do you still feel pretty good about that decision?
Really good. And everything I see in practice even gives me more confidence. You know, before when he was kicking in practice, I didn't realize he wasn't putting much time into it.
Into the place kicking, right?
Yeah, he was putting all his time in kickoffs.
Sure.
And so, you know, his field goal kicking during practice were really erratic. But, you know, since we made the change, or knew that we were making a change, he's, you know, put more time and energy into it and more focus into it, and he's doing really well.
Can you talk about what a tough son of a gun Jake Zuzek is? I see him all the time with ailments here in practice. He may miss a practice here or there, or he's got an ice bag, but every game he shows up, he's got that incredibly long starting streak. I mean, it's got to be one of the toughest kids on your team.
Well, I mean, you know, he's got his knees swollen, you know what I mean, and when you ask him how's he doing, he's doing great. You know what I mean? It just like you said, he just comes to work. You know, it's going to take a lot for him not to play. You know what I mean? But like you said, he's hurting everywhere. When you play guard in this offense,
it's a tough road.
You can't hide. You know what I mean? Because every snap you're running into somebody, and he's done that for 4 years. And like you said, for him to play all these games is pretty remarkable.
Homecoming, it's obviously a very big deal to the alums, the fans, etc. You all, does it matter to you? It's a game, right?
All we see is between the white lines. You know, I mean, it's nice to have fans there and to have them be, you know, cheering and rowdy. You know, we definitely need the home field advantage. But we don't know if it's Boy Scout Day,
right,
or, you know, free pizza day. I mean, we're trying to figure out, you know, when to blitz, you know, what are their, you know, number one pass coverages. And, you know, our marketing people, athletic department, sports information department, do a great job with all this stuff. We let them take care of that, and hopefully we try to win the game.
All right. Thank you, coach. I mean, they're all four teams, UCLA, Colorado, San Jose State, and Navy, are all doing something special. Is it sort of a tribute to your brother to kind of uplift him? Tell me your thoughts.
I think it's real cool. You know, any opportunity that the nation gets to support my brother and the Lymphoma Research Foundation is good for him and good for others that are infected with the disease, so it's a good deal.
Parrish, good to see you. Write a little story about the secondary. It seems like the group has been playing pretty well. Three of the top six tacklers on the team are in the secondary. Kind of, you know, as a leader back there, what's your thought on how the group has been coming along?
I think we're playing okay. I mean, we could definitely play better. As long as we're not getting no touchdowns, I mean, we're doing our job. Mm-hmm. Deep balls. But, yeah, I think we're playing fairly well, but, I mean, we can always get better.
Talk a little bit about how Quazell has adapted to the Rover role. He played corner. He moved over. He seems to be playing pretty well. I think he's, like, third on the team in tackles. Kind of your thoughts on how he's coming along?
Quazell, I think he's doing a real good job with the transition. I mean, he's doing exactly what that position is supposed to do, which is make tackles for us and be, like, another linebacker for us. So I think he's doing a great job. I think he's been in the film room, studied, and I think he's adapted to the position well.
Now, I mean, statistically, the unit's playing well, but it sounds like you have higher expectations, or you feel like they're, and when you look on film, are there things you can do better?
Always. I mean, we're not even close, but, I mean, if we keep ourselves, you know, humble and, you know, with the right attitude, then, I mean, we'll just keep getting better, keep going forward, And then, I mean, I can't say that we're playing great right now. Because we can have more wins, obviously. Mm-hmm. So as a DB Corps, I mean, we got to do all we can to get those, to help contribute to those wins.
What about yourself? You have 3 picks, a couple pass breakups. I mean, that's your free safety role, is to be the last line of defense. Do you feel pretty good about how you've been playing so far, Parrish?
Yeah, I do, but, you know, I mean, I can always do better. I'm playing for my teammates, playing for the one next to me, so, yeah.
And do you feel like it's your job to kind of coordinate the group back there? Are you the guy calling the signals and making sure everybody's lined up right?
Yeah, of course, mm-hmm. Of course, yeah. Everybody looks to me for, you know, advice, technique-wise, or whether that's do I need to move over a little bit on this play, move over in the game, out of the game situations, always.
All right, thanks, bud. A little story about the secondary. I just was looking at the numbers, and 3 of the top six tacklers on the team are in the secondary. That's kind of unusual. Are you pretty pleased with what you're seeing back there?
You know, always can get better. That's the bottom line. We got to get better and play much better this Saturday, and got to play better the rest of the year. You know, hopefully all week. Worked on fundamentals, trying to get better at each position, and that's a big goal. We got to play better this Saturday.
Talk a little bit about the Quazelle and the transition he's made. It looks like he's been playing fairly well, pretty solid. Are you happy with the transition that he's made into Rover?
Yeah, I think so. You know, he's had some growing pains, but he's come up the Rover spot. You got to come up and make some tackles when it breaks to first and second level. And also, you know, you got to be there in short yardage for some big plays at the Rover spot. So, he's done some good things throughout the year. I mean, a little growing pains at first, but I think he's adapted and, he's done a good job.
Brendan had a great freshman year. I think he's played even better this mm-hmm. year. One thing I noticed about him is he makes a lot of tackles in space. One-on-one tackles in space, yeah. Which are the most difficult, and he seems to always execute. What can you say about Brendan?
He really does a good job of getting off blocks, especially on, you know, I can recall a lot of bubble third down plays where he's mm-hmm. gotten off blocks and beating the block and made mm-hmm. tackle in open space, and he just made a lot of a really good plays for us this year doing that, making tackles in open space, which is what a corner's got to do, you know, get something on the ground and get a third down stop.
Quincy was obviously got pushed into the starting lineup when you moved Quazelle inside. It appears as though he's really stepped up and played pretty well. Your thoughts on how
Quincy's had the best year since he's been here. I think Quincy's been the most solid DB that we've had from game one to now. Mm-hmm. I think his performance has been consistent, and he's been, to me, the most consistent DB each game that we've had to this point.
And Parrish is the leader back there. I mean, he doesn't have as many tackles as the other guys, but he's mm-hmm. not going to as the free safety. But he has been ball hawking pretty good, 3 picks, mm-hmm. a couple pass breaks up. Do you feel Parrish is playing well?
Well, I hope Parrish doesn't have to tackle a whole lot because he's right. The deep safety, the free safety. But, yeah, right. He gets his lined up. He takes care of all the checks back there. And moving him from corner to safety through midseason last year paid great dividends for us a year ago. And he's been a true leader for us. He's made some big picks, some big plays, and hopefully the last half of the season he's going to continue to get better and make more.
Now, I know you've used Meyer Crawl in there mm-hmm. as a backup cornerback at times. I don't know, who else have you been using in there? Who else is getting into most games?
Meyer has gone in. He's first guy to go in at corner, and George Jamerson is first guy to go in at safety. Mm-hmm. Quasi a little banged up, and George went in for him, and I can't remember whether it's Quincy or Brendan went out, but Meyer went in. But those are 2 first guys to go in.
And is Meyer the nickel?
Meyer's the nickel. But we've mainly gone with Chris. You know, CJ is a nickel guy because he's done such a good job of getting his hands on receivers.
Okay, so you don't normally swap a linebacker around.
No,
okay.
We've mainly kept CJ in there as long as he stays healthy.
Okay. And then real quick, with the San Jose State offense, this quarterback seems to be developing. They spent a lot of time during their teleconference today, this week, talking about his development. Obviously, David Fales is in the NFL now, mm-hmm. and has fallen on this kid's shoulders, but have you seen some pretty good stuff out of him?
Well coached, and you can see from the time he became the starter to the last game, complete control of offense, doesn't make mistakes, does a great job managing the clock. You give him pressure, whatever you give him, he finds the open receiver real quickly. Big time impressed with this guy. He's done a great job.
All right. Thanks, buddy.
Yep, thanks. Hey, buddy.